Hello and welcome to our mighty Yangtze biodiversity series. We are broadcasting live from Anhui Xuancheng's Alligator National Nature Reserve. I'm Jiao Yang and I should introduce you to my co-host, Yang Yang, my namesake. And this is the mascot for the natural reserve. So we're going to be taking you around here. This is a place that's probably not normally on every tourist's radar, but we are here because it is really special. It's on our radar because it houses alligators, and not just any alligators, a very critically endangered species of alligators in China, in the world. Experts say that there are possibly only about 200 of them in the world right now, and they're mostly here in China. So this area, you know, because of human development and all this, the numbers have become really low, but of course conservationists put their mind to changing things, and here we are. We're in this reserve where, due to successful human breeding, we're looking at possibly over 10,000 alligators here, absolutely crawling with them. So before we get to the alligators, just to let me have my quick Sir David Attenborough moment. The Chinese alligator, as it's called, or the Yangtze alligator, it's endemic to China. It's only one of two species of alligators in the world. The other, the American cousin, is, as the name suggests, in the Americas. And here we are. I think we're getting close to the ponds now, so we're going to get to have a look at our star of the show today. So brace yourselves. Might not be as cute as this thing we're seeing here. Let's see if we can catch a sighting of them. Da, 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 da. I'm not sure if the Jaws music is appropriate, and there they are. So not quite as ferocious and aggressive as you might associate with alligators. They're really incredibly static. Wow. Well, I don't think we're at any danger right now. Well, this is surprisingly still, to be honest. I was expecting a little bit more action. All right, well, maybe we can find out a little bit more about these alligators and why it is that they're so still. And we're here with our expert. So we're here with Jiang Xuanqing. So he works for the Nature Reserve, and he's been here for 30 years, and he's helped to deal with the human breeding of these alligators and also to eventually reintroduce them back into the wild. So, Jiang Guzhang, you're dead on your lap. So I'm going to ask a little bit more about these alligators here.
讲课长，就这些鳄鱼、羊子和我们想象中的羊子鳄是完全不同的。我感觉我们想象中他们很凶猛，但是他们怎么这么近呢？嗯，是这样子的，羊子鳄呢是所有鳄鱼里面性格是最温驯的，一般不会主动攻击人，或者体型比较大的物体。它是爬树爬行动物，主要是营养吸生。
一部分时间生活在岸上，一部分时间呢生活在水里。它的取食呢主要是以这个水生类的这个动物，像是鱼啊、虾、那个河蚌、螺类。所以不会袭击人类是吗？大型的动物也。主动的那个攻击人类。啊，性格还是比较温顺的。在所有鳄鱼里面呢，它的体型算是最小的一类。 So these alligators are apparently, it's really not what we imagine. They're actually quite gentle. They've got quite gentle personalities. And Mr. Jiang here is telling me that they're very still. They just like to kind of rest here in the day and take their time. And actually the smaller of the alligators of the two species, 那他们美国的短吻鳄是有他们的两倍长，是吗？
嗯，对，那个美那个，它虽然和美国的密鳄是
So the American cousins of these alligators we're seeing here, the Chinese ones could be twice as big and twice as heavy. 那蒋科长，我们现在看到的这些鳄鱼是有大概几岁呢？这些鳄鱼就是应该都是超过10岁以上了，啊，已经这个是成年了。嗯，你看到这个。
现在目前这个阶段是应该是羊子鳄最娴熟的一个阶段，因为经过这个活动期的取食以后啊， 它体内已经积累了足够的营养和的脂肪，嗯，大家可以看一下它的尾部。
看一下它的扬子鳄的尾部是吗？啊，它的尾部从尾部能看出什么呢？
它尾部你看有一条的这个凹槽，那有一条明显的凹槽，如果它那个营养足够或者脂肪足够的话，它这个凹槽会丰满一点，啊，这个是为它这个移动的时候积累这个能量。
All right, so we're gonna take a closer look at their tail here. So apparently their tails show you how well provided for they are in terms of nutrients. So the alligators that we're looking at right now in this pond are about 10, they're at least 10 years old, which means that they're already a full adult size. 那大概有1米5吗？就这些10岁的，
这个
about 1.5 meters.
大部分应该有1.8以上，
啊，1米8。So they're taller than I am. They're about 1.5 meters. So these are the adults that have been successfully bred here. 那他们现在就是等待在越冬，是吗？是鳄，叫扬子鳄是会冬眠过冬。
对，它现在是正好是处于一个那个活动期和冬眠期的一个过渡期，它现在呢就是停止进食了，但是呢它还没有进入这个休眠状态。
So it looks like we're here in a bit of an awkward time for the alligators. So alligators hibernate, which might surprise you. So they're in the stage right now, sort of the transition stage, between having eaten loads, boosted their intake, and now getting ready for hibernation, which explains why they're so still. 那蒋科长，我们有什么办法能让，就是怎么样能让这些鳄鱼动起来呢？他们现在这个阶段就是已经不再投食了，那他们不会因为这个人的到来而有一些啊，有一只在动，有一只是要上岸了。那我们有什么办法能，
那如果在活动期的话，一般听到鹦鹉的叫声呢，它可能会有所反应。但是现在这个季节啊，它不一定有反应。现在可以放一下试试看。
幼鳄的叫声。
对。
All right, Mr. Jiang is going to try and help us get these alligators moving a little bit. And he's going to, he said he has a recording of, oh, there it is. 这是幼鳄的叫声。
对，会放出声的幼鳄。
Well, that's spectacular. That's the sound of baby crocodiles. I didn't even know they bellowed. Sounds like little radar sounds. But absolutely no reactions from our alligators here, though. Is it possible that these are dads? 有没有可能是因为这些是公鳄呢，所以他们听到孩子的声音不会有什么反应呢？
这个池子里面，它是公鹅和雌鹅是在一起的。
There's mums and dads here, but what mums often say, that dads can sleep through the night even if the baby's crying. Maybe these are
你
dads
看一下
here.
它游动的方式，它是主要是靠尾部来推进的，就像那个船的桨一样。
So the alligator that we're looking at right now that's swimming through the pond. So Mr. Jiang is telling me that the way its tail is moving, 这个是就是正常的游动方式吗？
对，它是扬子鳄在水里面的这个游动方式，它主要是靠尾部这个摆动来推进，
It's
给它一个向前的力量，向前那个。但是呢，我们现在看到了这个是人工繁育的扬子鳄，它在游动的时候，相对来说可以看到整个个体在动。但是在野外呢，扬子鳄的这个游动的时候，或者移动的在水里面移动的时候，不会这么明显，一般它仅仅是露出一个头。它这个是跟它这个在野外啊，它这个获取食物的方式有关系。
就
扬
这样
子
子，
鳄，
它的隐秘性就更强一
对，
些，是
扬，
吧？在野外。
在野外扬子鳄这个获取食物呢，一个主要是靠这个顿食或者偷袭。这样子呢，它就要求它的行动啊，要有这个隐蔽性和突然性。所以讲，它行动的时候一般都是悄无声息的。
所以等于是在我们的这个养殖区内，它们已经很放松了，才会这样
对，
子大幅度的动，是
这
吗？
个我们人工繁育的扬子鳄呢，会人工投喂。然后定时就是每到喂食的时候呢，就定时会投喂到一个固定的地方，这样子它可能，对于获取食物不是它最紧迫的事情，所以说呢，它这个游动的时候很放松。
So the alligators here are obviously in a more relaxed state than they would be in the wild. And Mr. Jiang was just pointing out to us that the way it's swimming around, moving its tail, that's what propels them through the water, right? And it moves at a much bigger sort of breadth here in the nature reserve than the alligators would in the wild, because obviously being discreet is everything to hunting to them in the wild. But here they can take it easy because they get their lunch and dinners served to them routinely. So in the wild, you wouldn't see them moving like this, and you probably only see a little bit of their heads, maybe just a bit of the snout. Definitely not so much movement in the water. 那之前您给我们听到的是那个小小鳄鱼的幼鳄的声音。那这个扬子鳄它大了，就成年的鳄会发出什么样的声音呢？ I'm gonna have a listen to. I want to find out a bit more about the way they communicate to each other. We just heard the babies. 刚才那是幼鳄，就等于说是呼叫妈妈，是吗？它幼鳄，它可能它受到威胁或者受到限制，或者它有什么需求的时候，它会发出这种叫声。 So the sound that we heard earlier, the recording, that's of the babies, you know, possibly under threat, trying to call for help from its mother. And let's hear what the adults sound like.
像这种那个年龄这个扬子鳄呢，它一般发出是吼叫声，因为扬子它没有声带，它只是通过肺部的气流冲击那个上颚啊，它发出了一种低沉的吼声，类似于这个猪的吼叫声，所以它扬子鳄在民间啊，它也叫猪婆龙，大家可以听一下。
Almost sounds like frogs. That's the sound of an adult alligator. And apparently they have no vocal cords. So they're essentially mute, but they make these noises from the vibrations in the air with their, I guess, what is that? This is their jaw sac?
但是它一般是发出吼叫呢，一般一个是求偶的季节，这个会发出这个吼叫，然后天气变化的时候。
天气变化的时候，对，或者气压比较低的时候，感觉到要下雨的时候，哦，也会发出吼叫，像是下雨天的预警哈。或者它遭受比较大的惊吓，或者这个应激反应的时候，它也会发出这个吼叫声。So it makes these noises. I mean, you know, they are very silent and still right now, but it makes these noises when during mating season. I guess that's their way of attracting a mate. And also apparently when the pressure changes, it's almost like a weather vane. They'll start bellowing to indicate when rain might be coming and also if it comes under threat.
那这么说明的话，这些扬子鳄就是对我们已经很适应人类了，咱们这边那就对我们丝毫没有反应哈。它相对来讲跟这个野外这个野生的扬子鳄，它可能对这个人的警惕性啊，或者这个人活动的干扰啊，它更迟钝一点。
嗯，
大家可以看。 看这个池子里面，鳄鱼的密度可能感觉到密度很大，这是我们现在人工饲养的这个区域。这个每个池子一般就是池子大小，都放一100到200条左右的这个扬子鳄。大家看到这个场，这个扬子鳄在野外它是，
100到200条。
对，扬子鳄在野外它是要营造洞穴的，它冬天是在洞穴里面过冬。等一下我们在那个。 反正去的时候会看到那个洞穴，好像是这个地方呢，它是没有，你看到没有洞穴，这一块呢就是冬天了，这所有的鳄鱼都要找回我们的这个跃动室，人工营造的这个跃动的环境，去给它过冬。So
we're looking at about there's about 200 or so alligators in this pond, and apparently they hibernate in the winter in these caves. So they dig these extensive underground caves, and you know they will have their own individual chambers. 那这边水深有多少呢？这边水深一般是1.2到1.5米。It's about 1.2 to 1.5 meters deep here. 那咱们这里有多少池子呢？能继续看走走看看。咱们这边一共有几个池子呢？
这个大大小小的有，它是根据这个池子，根据我们这个扬子鳄啊，这个在放到池子里面时候，它是基本上差不多大规格的，它放在一个池子里。我们这边大大小小的池子应该有20多个。
大大小小池子20多个，right? So they keep the alligators in the same age group. 这样子就是为了防止他们有这种争吵或者占地盘的这种打架，是吗？
这样子是便于那个饲养管理，因为这个大小这个规格不同的扬子鳄啊。 在取食啊，或者是这个能力上面都是有差异的。尽量让规格差不多大小的样子在同一个池子里面，这样他们取食可能更平均一点。
I guess it's like the school system. You keep them in their similar age group so that you can, help the way they feed, the way they move about and go about their daily lives would be kind of fairly similar. So these are the bigger ones. 这些就是年龄最大的了，是吗？差不多。
这个不是年龄最大。
哦，还有更大的哈，那一会儿去看看。These aren't the oldest ones that they have here, but they're pretty big. And then there's about 20 or so ponds here, 20 or so classes for the different aged alligators. 那咱们这边看到的池子，哦，我看到那个岸上有几条杨泽，这个年龄都在多大呢？
这个是在7、8年左右，7、8岁左右。
These are about 7 to 8 years old. They're just lazing in the sun like this. 他们白天就是晒太阳。
是这样子的，因为现在正好是这个活动期，像冬眠期、过渡期这个季节，相对来说，它现在基本上白天就是坐在岸边不动，那个晒太阳，但是在野外呢，它有部分鱼呢，它现在还在营造洞穴，还有。
Right, so they're still, because I mean, this is because these ones are pretty lucky. They get to lounge as they're in a protected nature reserve. But in the wild, this is the period of time where they'd have to get really busy and start digging their holes for the winter.
这两个平台呢，你看到这有两个平台，这个就是平常我们进行投喂的时候，把鱼啊或者其他一些饲料就放在这地方，然后也养殖会，全部集中到这个地方来取食。
一天投喂几次呢？
它是像这么大的一个鱼，我们一般3天喂一次。
哦，3天喂一次啊，So these platforms that the alligators are resting on, sunbathing on, these are where they would put the food, where the staff here would put the food, and it would be but alligators about this age, they'd be fed maybe once every 3 days. 那他们这段时间就不吃，不再进食，他们这储存的营养够吗？够过冬吗？能到明年什么时候才冬眠结束呢？
它是这样子的，这个一般我们是在11月底，然后把这池水放干，然后用人工把它抓回去，进行清洗消毒，然后进入这个喂冬室进行冬眠。一般来年的3月底，一般是惊蛰过后，室外的这个气温比较稳定了，然后再把它投放到这个池子里面。
So these guys hibernate from about December, end of November until March next year. So they've had to, really shore up on energy and nutrients for these few months. So Mr. Jiang's telling me that come winter, the staff here have to drain every single one of these ponds that we're looking at right now, and then pick the alligators up and then take them to a hibernation room so that they can spend the winter there. 所以您说的是把池子的水放干，然后是怎么抓这个鳄鱼呢？
一般都是徒手抓。
徒手抓 the staff just go in there and they pick up these alligators just with their bare hands, like everybody's a Steve Irwin. 那徒手抓不怕咬吗？
是这样子的，一般是在11月底的时候，气温很低，羊驼的这个反应和这个活动能力啊，随着这个气温的降低啊，它会逐渐降低。一直最低的时候是在冬眠的状态，它呈这个睡眠的状态，就是不动。相对来讲，我们11月底的时候呢，抓它的危险性要小一点，但是前提也是要把它的嘴先抓住，然后把它抱起来。
Apparently they're at a fairly low energy levels around that time. So end of November is when they start this momentous task of moving the alligators, and they don't fight back or struggle quite as much. So they literally the staff just go in there. They just pick them up. 用手先抓住嘴是吗？
对，把它稳住抓住。
So they grab. Wow. Oh, before I get back on that, 那他刚才是不是被我们吓着了吗？
它这个就是人的响动啊，
哦，
它，
您听。
对，这个就是应急的反应的吼叫。
Oh wow, so that's basically like their emergency call right now. They just sense this coming, and I guess we disturb their peace. Sorry. Wow. And there it is. That's the alligators bellowing there. 所以您刚才说什么？就是直接拿手抓住他们的吻。 然
样子，
后，
它是这个嘴，它主要，它羊子这个攻击那个防御或者攻击的手段主要是两种，一种是这个用嘴咬嘛，它因为它这个咬合力还是挺惊人的，第二个呢是用尾部扫，相对来说我们把这个把它的嘴控制住了就可以，这样就不容易就伤害不到捕捉的人了。
不怕爪子吗？
爪子，相对来讲，这个
没有那么
锋，
锋利。
对。
哦，是吗？So apparently the alligators, the parts that you should watch out for, their snout. Obviously, they have really incredible bites and teeth, and also their tail. So they swish with their tail, and that's the way that they, get rid of their enemies and catch their prey. So staff here, they just have to make sure that they keep a tight grip on the snout, on the mouth, and keep the tail under control. And then that's it. They carry them over. 就是那这样子的话，咱们这边这几个池塘有几千，有多少条鳄鱼呢？
这个区域应该有个4、5千条。
四五千条，about 4 or 5 thousand alligators in just this area here. 那这个工程就是把他们越冬搬到这个越冬市的工程需要多久呢
一般10天左右。
？Takes about 10 days to get all these alligators nicely settled into their abode for the winter.
但是把整个所有的鳄鱼要搬到越冬市里面，大概条数应该是在1万条左右。
1万条左右。
就是要放到这个越冬那个卵房里面越冬。
Wow, so just a few thousand here, but altogether about 10,000 alligators that they have to move for the winter. 年轻子抓过。
抓过。
Mr. Chang here has been in there himself and grabbed these alligators. 您没被抓过，没被咬过。
咬也咬过的，但
哦，
是不是很严重嘛？
不是咬到哪儿了呢？
一般是咬到手。
He's been bitten before, but he says it was really not very serious. 没有血了吧？
流血是肯定的。
哇，勇敢，really brave man here that I'm walking along with. Got respect. He says it wasn't a very serious bite, but he has been bitten before when he's, been personally involved in getting these alligators out. 那我们现在这里看到的鳄鱼大概年龄有多大呢？
这个区域的话呢，这个整个年龄大致都差不多，一般的7、8岁啊，或者10岁左右。
它不是相通的，是吧？这些池子。
对，这所有的这个池子都是独立的、分开的。
您估计您搬运过几条鳄鱼呢？这么多年，
这个几千条鳄鱼肯定是搬过
几
来的。
千条。Mr. Jiang thinks he must have carried about a few thousand alligators over to their winter homes. That's incredible.
有的鳄鱼不止搬一次啊，年龄要搬。
They encounter some old friends every winter. 哇，那这边的池子是，我觉得这个好像是不是大小更，这个好像看体积觉得更小一些，是吧？
对，这边年龄稍微要小一点，这个池子要小一点。
So actually, wow. So check out these ponds here. I don't know if you can notice, but the platforms that they're resting on are arranged in the yin yang I Ching pattern. So I guess these alligators are working on their chi here as well. 咱们这池子还是挺特殊的设计的哈。
这个啊，因为这个区域也开展生态旅游嘛，所以有一点造型。这个是太极，这个八卦。
So these are fairly young alligators as well. 那蒋科长，为什么这些鳄鱼你看它们都堆在一起？这有什么原因吗？就是不这样舒服吗？主要是。
这个在我们人工饲养的鳄鱼，它两个特性，一个它是一个喜欢打洞，第二个呢，它喜欢这个堆在一起。
They're all piled on top of each other. Oh wow, look at them scuttling away. 就是因为害怕我们，
对，
就
他
警
就是
惕是吗？
感觉到有那个，
哦，
就受到这个人的这个惊扰啊。
This is the most I've seen these alligators move since we started walking around. So they probably are feeling a bit of threat from us walking around. 那如果是在野生的话，就是他们野生的环境，那我们是不是基本上就看不到这些鳄鱼呢？他们的警觉性如果那么高的话，他们是会就是会藏起来吗？
在野外，它很不容易发现。它相对来讲，是它如果起时活动也，其实也是在比较隐蔽的地方。
So I guess if you were to take a gander in the wetlands in the wild, it'd probably hard-pressed to actually spot one of these alligators. I mean, they're really well camouflaged, and they would just hide away. They wouldn't want to come near us. 那野生的和咱们养殖的，就是它在这个外表上会有任何区别吗？
这个野生的，我们人工养的，相对的看上去呢，这个体型啊偏胖一些，
啊、哦，吃得好，
吃好
营
一
养
些。
太好，
然后呢，这个颜色呢稍微淡一点，然后在野外呢，
颜色淡一些
在野外呢，这个肤色呢可能更黝黑一点，然后更发亮一点。
啊。啊，
然后呢，它这个体型呢更匀称，
为什么会更发亮一些呢？在野外。
在野外它可能，相对呢可能跟环境也有关系。
哦，so the ones that you see in the wild would be a lot darker than these, but also shinier. And Mr. Jiang says, obviously, these are pretty well fed, so they're a lot bigger than the alligators we would see in the wild, if you're lucky enough to spot one in the wild. So these alligators are.
在野外的这个养殖的这个活动的范围和量，肯定是比这个人工驯养的繁育的要这个大得多。
大得多，范围大得多，活动范围大得多。
你看它这个在人工那个繁育的这个，它就活动范围就这么一个池子，但是在野外的话，一条鳄鱼养殖个活动范围可能有几公里。
那鳄鱼是扬子鳄是属于独居的吗？还是他们喜欢这种抱团儿？
它基本上，它每条羊都会有一个领域。
哦，
它
他们。
如果栖息地足够的话，
嗯。
它还是每条它有一个相对独立的一个区域。
哦，它不会说是公母这样子一对儿在一起，或者说一条公的和几条母的，它是就是不分性别、不分这样子的这种团居的活动吗？
它那个一般都是独居。
哦，都是独居的。These are lone wolves apparently, so a bit different here, obviously where they don't have as much space as in the wild, but left to their own devices apparently. Alligators like their own space. 那咱们现在野外的话是有，大概多少条杨子鳄？
它是这样子的，它野外呢一个就是野生的羊子鳄呢是在目前是在200多条，然后呢我们从2003年到这个今年，一共进行了17次的野外放归，这个期间呢放归了1038条的羊子鳄，然后。
咱们这个自然保护区是哇，他们跑起来其实是非常快的，是吗？你看他们这么近，但是一旦动起来，是速度非常快。
很快。
So that's quite the contrast. And you see them just lounging there like that, but the moment they feel threat, and I guess if they're hunting as well, they would just that's sharp, that's quick movement there. So this reserve, Mr. Xiang tells me that there are about they counted about maybe 200 or so, 200 or so wild alligators. But obviously the reserve is breeding these alligators and eventually reintroducing them to the wild. So since 2003, they managed to introduce. They said they've had 17 counts of trying to introduce these bred alligators back into the wild and have probably he said around 1,000 or so, just above 1,000 alligators.
羊子鳄它受到这个比较大的威胁的时候，它一般是2种策略。第一种策略，第一选择呢，它首先是逃跑，速度很快。如果就是发现无处可逃的时候，它就
攻击。
选择对峙，
哦，对哦。
然
所以
后把，
攻击是最后的这个，
对，
是下策是吗？
对峙的时候呢，它把头朝着这个受威胁的方向，然后张嘴，呼气。然后把那个四肢撑起来。
那所以他们不看我们，说明我目前来说我们还对他们不造成太多危险，是吗？So if they come under threat, these alligators, their top strategy is to just run. So not the most confrontational. And only when they feel like they have no other option would they turn around. Would they turn around and then they would face off their enemy, their opponent. It sounds like they're not very aggressive at all. 那这些扬子鳄在放回到这个野外的时候，放归野外的时候，就是怎么去挑选哪些扬子鳄往野外放呢？
是这
有
样
什么
的，首
标
先，
准吗？
首先从我们这个人工繁育的这所有羊子里面进行体格检查，选择这个体态匀称、发育良好的，然后再进行这个一些兽医检查，然后看挑选没有缺陷的，然后呢再进行这个遗传背景分析，
遗传背景分
把他
析。
们这个然后放到这个野化训练室进行模拟野外的环境，进行这个野化训练。
So these alligators, when they get reintroduced back into the wild, they have to go through training, and they get taken to a training center. So not only do they have to sift through all their criteria and make sure that they're, genetically strong, and all kinds of other standards have to be met. And then when they're deemed strong enough, they get trained and then put back into the wild. 那一般都会在多大的扬子鳄才会放归野外？哇，a lot of movement over there.
一般是6到7岁。
6到7岁，那就是大概是咱们右边看到的这些扬子鳄的这个大小了。So the ones that get put back into the wild are maybe about 6 or 7 years old. So the ones that we were just walking past earlier. 都有什么样的培训呢？
是这样子，它是在我们保护区专门在那个狼溪的高级苗片区，它建了一块这个野化训练基地。然后呢，用围栏隔出一个相对封闭的区域，但是这个区域呢是模拟这个羊这个野外的栖息地，然后把这个野化训练就挑选好的野化训练的羊这个放到这个训练区，然后呢就是我们给它构造这个食物链，它自己自主的这个觅食，
捕猎是
对，
吧？
自主的觅食，然后打洞、营巢、繁殖，
但是这些都不用教吗？
它这个养这个一般，它比如像捕食、营造洞穴、那个筑巢，这个它这个是与生俱来的。
So they pick out a little area for as the training ground for these alligators that are getting put back into the wild, and there, they have to hunt for their own food, so they'll have 就是活的鱼，然后鸟类是吧？So kind of live animals, and they have to try and catch their own food. I don't know, that must be a big change for them, having gone from this kind of luxury to suddenly having to fend for themselves completely, and they'd have to learn how to burrow as well. But Mr. Jiang says that. But they don't need talk. They don't need teaching, really. It just comes to them naturally. 这些鳄鱼都很小哈，感觉这个鳄鱼也就几岁吧。
这个是四岁左右。
These about four. 所以我感觉好像就是越小，它们对我们的反应就会越大。这个跟年龄和成熟度也有一定关系
对，有一定关系。它能力强了嘛，它可能对于这个威胁的
嘛。
这个承受能力可能更强一点。
对，像那些大的跟我们的。跟我的跟比我还高，所以比我还长，所以肯定就不那么大。Looks like the younger they are, the more they're reacting to us as we're walking past。哎，蒋老师，蒋哥，您看这边的水就很清淡，这边长了很多，这个水上面浮了好多，这是浮萍是吗？
对，浮萍和这个一种水葫芦，这个主要的就是消耗里面的这个富营养化。它因为养这个这么多条羊，这个在里面这个生活，它这个水的这个氮磷含量更高一点，就是
对他们不影响是吗？
对养这个主要它是靠肺呼吸的，相对来讲水质的这个变化呢，对它的影响小一点。
So these ponds that you're seeing with all this green stuff, that's not algae or moss, that's duckweed apparently. The symbiotic relationship they have with the alligators here. They feed off, thrive off the alligators' excrements, and they provide good cover for them. 那就是其实也给他们提供了这个。等于说一个掩盖是吧？
主要的还是想把这个水的这个富氧化减轻一点。
Apparently these have a purification properties. These duckweeds they help to get rid of some of the chemicals in there. 那这里的环境跟那边挺大不同的。
这个就是我们那个子二代繁殖区，
子二代是什么意思呢？
是这样子。我们这个人工繁育的这个所有的鳄鱼啊，都是从这个一开始 79年这个建扬子河繁殖场的时候，从野外就是，
79年建的
啊对，从野外就是收容了这个212条这个野生的扬子鹅，然后作为这个亲本鹅，它是第一代的。然后呢，那个这一代的这个鳄鱼呢，产蛋以后孵出来不是幼鹅了吗？然后长大了以后又繁殖了以后，从野外抓回来的是剩下的是一代，然后子一代，然后再产下来，也就是二
野
代。
外抓回来是一代，
把野外
因为
抓回
产
来，
下来的是一代，
产下来是一
然后他们再产的是二代。
代，二代，然后这些鳄鱼现在它已经开始繁殖了。
Right. So actually, this pond that we're looking at right now, this is quite interesting. This is sort of like second generation immigrants, I suppose. So when they first established this reserve back in the 70s, they took some good specimens from the wild and brought them into this reserve. And the eggs that they laid and the babies that hatched from that's the first generation migrants, I suppose. And then these are now the second generation of the alligators from the wild. 那他们这个环境也其实也更模拟野生了，是吧？
这个繁殖区的环境呢，基本上也是模拟野外的这个养这个栖息地的环境。
So what, if you look around, you know, this is it's basically the kind of environment, the habitat that these alligators would be living in the past, and would be now, I guess, with the wild populations.
这个里面的养这个呢，它是会自己打洞。你看，在那边树这个隐蔽下面呢有洞口。这个他们这个养这个呢，它是不会抓回去的，它冬天它自己在这个洞里面运动。然后到6月下旬到7月上旬呢，它这个会在这个岛上和岸上去产蛋。
So over there on the far side of this pond, that's where the alligators would actually burrow and make their own, I guess their palaces. Pretty big, extensive maze-like things.
然后呢，这个蛋呢，它是产在它自己住的这个巢里面，它主要的就是这个母鹅，它会嗅觉这个岸上的这个枯枝落叶啊，它会堆成一个几十，应该是1米。
你看那个就那个在游动起来就非常的静哈，你看它尾巴就不怎么在动，就和我们在那些池塘里看到的还是有一些不同。
但是这个在野外看不会看到
看
这
不
么。
到这么多，就露一个鼻子和眼睛是吗？
对。
This is one sort of leisurely swimming along there. Still, that would be far more of the alligator than we would ever see in the wild. 那这些年龄应该都相当大了哈。
对，这个应该有这个20几岁。
These are in their 20s。蒋科长，我们这个沿路看到的这个字，就是这个
那个妥字，
妥字。
不同的这个书写的形体。
So the words that we're seeing here, they all look incredibly different, probably to the untrained eye, but it's actually all of the same character in Chinese, the character 妥, and that is 妥的意思就是什么？是
这个是这样的，
龙还是？
扬子鳄呢，是我们这个现代的这个一个命名。然后在古代的这个典籍里面，这个扬子鳄就是写着称作妥。
So obviously the alligator now, this is our the modern day rendition of their name, but in the past this is how they would have called the alligators. I think it means something like 就土龙是吧？也叫土龙是吧？
对，就是当地老百姓叫土龙。那个这个妥字啊。应该是个典型的象形字。如果你看那个字的话，应该是和这个我们扬子鳄的这个整个的形体啊，应该有一个非常的神似。那上面两个口子就是一个典型的它的两个眼睛。
Yeah, so this word itself actually looks, it's sort of meant to resemble the alligator, you know, these two squares that you're seeing here, it's like their eyes, and 那这就是长的尾巴了，是吧？ And that would be the tail. So obviously, a lot of Chinese characters are pictograms, and this word is no exception, tuo, which is the old word for alligators, and means earth, muddy dragon, which is, I guess, what people thought of them as in the past. 这些字您会写吗？ It's incredibly hard to write this. I think without the picture in front of me, I don't think I could write it either. 那这边的蛋，您说他们是在这边 扬子是在这边下，但他们是在什么哪个什么季节呢？
一般是在6月的下旬到7月的上旬，
啊，
这是他们的这个产蛋的季节。
产蛋的季节，
对，然
那。
后我们人工那个繁育的羊子呢，它会工作人员会在这个它下了蛋以后会在这个岛上会再把它那个蛋取回去，
哦，
然后进行人工孵化。等一下我们在那个科技中心啊就能看到它这个孵化，我在这里和这里放出它的这个幼鹅正在这个饲养。
So the alligators lay their eggs here on shore, and obviously this is a breeding center, so the staff here would actually collect the nest of eggs. They lay their eggs around July, June, July, just the early summer, and they would take the eggs and collect them all and then take them to a center where they would then try and incubate the eggs and let them hatch. And Mr. Jiang is going to take us over to that center now so that we can have a look. And 那边现在是有孵化出来的小宝宝是吧？
对，
他们是
我们可以去看一看。
那就是6到7月份产蛋，然后什么时候？那这个蛋的这个孵化期是多久呢？
孵化期一般是2个月，
两
根
个
据这
月。
个温度的这个在野外啊，它可能时间要长一点或者短一点，根据这个环境温度的这个高低。我们人工抚育的话，那个孵化的话，一般是在56天左右，
16天，
56天。
哦，56天，哦。So they incubate for about 2 months or so, which means it can be a little shorter under, human conditions, artificially incubated conditions. So which means that they've got a batch of fresh little babies there that we can go and visit. Get on the cart, get on our ride. 那我们就坐这个车，去上。谢谢。Right, we're gonna go see the babies now. There's actually a really nice scent in the air. 你觉得这整个园区里飘的都是那种桂花香味啊？
很好能看，现在这个气温猛然提了一下，把它吹开了。
So we're getting this nice whiff of osmanthus scent in the air. 所以我其实想象到的就是鳄鱼池这边会有一种腥味，但是咱们这儿完全没有，就环境太好了，是吗？
和这个冬眠的过渡期，然后它在活动期。
Incubation。那现在我们要一会儿看到的幼鳄的话，是大概有几个月大呢？
它是9月底刚孵出来
九
的，
月底孵出来
然后就
的。
饲养1个多月。
So we're going to be looking at some babies that are only about a month or so old. They would have hatched in September.
冬天呢，这个冻结了以后呢，会有一部分鱼放在这个里面，就是这是给这个游客在冬天来参观的。
So this is where some of the hibernating alligators would be placed for the winter, and this is, you know, where tourists can come in and have a look. 那我们从这边上去吗？哎，来先。All right, well, it seems like we may have had some signal issues earlier on as we were going over here. So in case you missed any of what we said, we were heading to the area where this is the kind of research lab where they incubate the eggs that they collect from, you know, that sort of model wild area. And then they incubate the eggs here and hatch them. So we're going to come and see some baby alligators now, not crocodiles, alligators that are only about a month old. 你好，哎，您带路。好，必须得消毒是吧 ？Okay, we're gonna get cleaned up here a little bit. 那 get anything dirty on our little babies. 就手上消毒，然后好，这个踩一下。Get rid of any nature. 谢谢。Oh, I feel like a scientist. 好，那您先带我们去看一下。那现在等于说已经没有这个孵化中的蛋了，是吧？
对，我们可以看一下这个我们进行这个人工孵化的这个地方。
So obviously all the eggs will have hatched by now, but Mr. Jiang is going to take us to have a look at some of the room where they would have kept the eggs. 那这些就是
这个呢，是我们从这个繁殖区把蛋取回来以后，就会放在这个房子里面孵化。然后呢，这个是我们这个一个孵化箱，就是木质的，杉木质的。然后呢，这个呢是，是这个呢就是杨子哥的蛋，这个蛋呢是不受精的蛋，现在已经做成了标本。我现在可以演示一下这个蛋的这个入孵的这个过程。这个蛋从这个是那个外面取回来以后呢，首先用那个毛巾把这个蛋擦干净，然后去除它的这个附着的脏物。然后呢，在这外面这个收蛋的时候呢，可以用这个铅笔在上面会做一个记号。在这上面呢，它来孵化进孵化室的时候呢，会把这个蛋按照这个方向放好。这样子呢，在上面呢，一般的这上面叫动物脊，这下面叫植物脊。
So these are all basically unfertilized eggs that they've drained the contents from them, and then you can just to give you an idea of what it looks like. So it's 这个就跟鸡蛋一样大哈 It's like the size of a regular egg, really, a little bit slender, a little bit longer than that. And they would collect the eggs from the reserve area and the breeding area, and then bring them here. 那就是说一窝是能叫一窝吗？这一窝大概有多少个蛋呢？
一般是在20到30枚之间。当然它个体差异，有可能是几枚，也可以可能很多，比如像40枚。但是一般是在20到30枚之间。
So you usually get about 20 or 30 eggs per nest. They bring them over in these carts and then label them correctly. Keep a record of everything. 蒋科长，那这边看到的这个草，这是草。是吗？这是用来，
这是我们孵化的草材，其实就是在野外长的苔藓，然后把它收集回来以后呢，进行清洗、晾晒、消毒以后，这个就是它孵化的时候呢，这个蛋啊，并不是在外面裸露的，它是需要在这个放在孵化箱里。
So this is moss that they've collected from the natural environment, and they bring it here. I mean, this is where the mother alligators would actually lay their eggs. They would lay them, and then, 所以他们就是母鳄是会产下蛋了之后，就是用这个把蛋给盖住，什么的，你说建一个堆。
对，现在我们人工孵化呢，是把这个草材，这个草当然是要喷湿的， 一
They'd
般
have
就
to
是，
spray water on it to keep it moist.
一般湿度在95%左右。
Pretty moist. I'm talking about 95% humidity, and this is what they would do. This is how the staff would nice place the eggs out
这是
evenly.
提前才要铺上。
那在野外野母鳄就是用这种苔藓。
母鳄在野外母鳄，它是随机的，它看那个环境周围环境有什么这个草啊、枯枝落叶啊，它是把扒在一起，它这个没有苔藓。这是我们经过选择的，因为苔藓一个不容易腐烂，第二个呢，它有含了水以后啊，它具有一定的这个透气性，所以呢是对于我们腐化呢，可以满足我们腐化的要求。
So again, these alligators here in the reserve are pretty lucky in that
在实际腐
they
化的时
get
候，它地方还
nice
要培树，
moss.
然后把这个蛋就是这样按照这个标记啊。这样子一个个的排好，
就盖一层。Give them a little bit of space in between.
我这个摆2层。
So in the wild, the alligator mummies would just gather whatever they can, really, whether it's branches or leaves or a little bit of earth, whatever they find to just cover up their eggs and keep them warm and safe.
这个摆上以后呢，然后就把再用一部分草材把
再
这个
盖
蛋
住。
盖住。
So about 56 days in this sort of environment for the eggs to hatch, about 2 months or so. Maybe a bit longer in the natural environment. That 他们需要在什么样的温度中孵化呢？
这个我们用这个在孵化的时候呢，是把温度控制在我们现在是控制在31，
They actually need pretty high temperatures to incubate here, about 30 or so degrees. 那我们能去看看这个小鳄吗？
可
孵
以。
化出来的小鳄。
然后呢，这个控制湿度呢，就是靠这个控制这个潮材的这个喷水，然后控制潮材的速度，从而控制这个蛋的这个孵化的湿度。
那您这边1个季度一般能收集到多少个蛋呢？
2、3千枚。
So each year they probably gather about 2 or 3 thousand eggs in total，然后都在这个房间里储存着。Wow, it's a lot of eggs to keep track of。江科长，我听说这个。我之前有读到过，说这个温度，孵化的温度可能有，就是有可能会影响这个杨子的性别，是这样子的吗？
经过一些这个研究呢，是杨子呢在28到28.5度左右呢，这个孵化温度呢，它出的92%是雌性，然后是
二十八啊，你是
二十
二十
八
八
到
到。
二十八点八点五度，然后29度到32.5度之间呢是雌雄的比例在1:1，然后是33度至34.5度之间呢是
雄性的可能
雄性的
性。
比例是在90%以上。
Apparently, the different temperatures can affect their gender. Lower temperatures mean that it's possible that it's more likely that there'll be female, higher temperatures male. Well, 这个温度相当高。I'm just getting this wave of warm air in my face right now. 哇，这就是小杨子鳄。
对。
These are the babies. Close to 2 months old. It's incredible. You look how small they are, and you imagine, and compare that to what we just saw. How? Wow. They must eat a lot during this time. 就很难想象从这么小变到，就我们刚看到的这种接近2米的这种长度
对，
哈。
它从孵化到长成一条大鳄鱼，应该还是经历了比较多的艰辛，
哇！哦，真的是。
尤其在野外。
那这些就是每一个池子里的，可能都是
同一
同一
窝的，
窝的， So each of these ponds, each of these basins you're seeing, this is one nest. So those are all brothers and sisters over there, getting to know each other well. Yangtze 问："还会有什么天敌吗？"
他们天天主要就是在从蛋，然后到幼鹅，一般在这3年以后，天敌就很少了。它主要的是孵化的时候，那个蛇，这个黄鼠狼，还有一些这个鼠类，可能会那个包括白蚁都会去吃它蛋。
那它们存活率，在野外的话和在这个咱们养殖地就比起来，大概多少？
野外这个从蛋完成就是从。蛋到这个一条成年的羊，这个它的这个，成长的频率。
Adult full size, so that is actually really low survival rates. No wonder they're pretty critically endangered. 现在它生出来的时候，刚孵出来的时候有多大呢？
当时孵出来的时候，一般是20厘米左右，20厘米左右。
20厘米左右，能长到2米。So when they first hatch, they're only about 20 centimeters. 现在这么看的话，有三十厘米了，
现在没有。
没有，30厘米也不到。还就是，那他们多久喂一次呢？
这个搞出现在是每天喂一次。
刚出生是2天喂一次，
每天喂一
每一
次。
天喂一次。They get fed once a day at the moment, and then soon it'll be every 3 days. It is incredibly warm in here. I mean, 这里面的温度可能有
28到30度。
it's about 28-30 degrees in there. Pretty cute, huh? More cuter than the stuff we saw out there. Whew, serious temperature difference. All right. Well, we've seen the moms and the dads, and we've seen the babies, and oh, I think we can hold one of them actually. 我们可以摸一只是吗？我的手已经消毒过了，是可以放在手上是吗？我可以亲自去拿吗？那您建议是怎么把它们，怎么样就是能减少这个对它们的伤害和影响呢？就从下面，从后面拖是吗？很难抓。哦，我感觉它很害怕。Oh, that is incredible. 我怕它会掉下来。Oh, wow. It's so light on the hand. That thing must be 这个有几克呢？可能也就
十几克。
十几克。It must be only about 10 grams or so, but they are incredibly sneaky. Oh, that's 非常感谢。Wow, that's incredible to see the difference, right? When you see when they're first hatched and to think how big they get. And they are so light on the hand. And one day they'll grow to this big, massive size. 那蒋科长非常感谢您给我们讲了这么多，
不客气。
也带我们看了这么多，真的是长知识了。I'm just thanking Mr. Jiang right now for giving us a tour of this place. I mean, this is incredible. I had never been this close to alligators, let alone put one in my hand. And I guess we'll wrap it up here. And we'll have more live broadcasts coming from here later on. So do tune in and we'll try and show you some other stuff from this park. Well, I'm Jiao Yang and this is Yang Yang, the mascot here. And this is Mr. Jiang. And thank you so much for joining in.
再见。